Once again on a draw, once against a capable hand, sadly. This is tricky. Like, I like Shrikorn as a reason to keep hands, but I have four cards I would love to mill, not to draw. And I'm on a draw, so if opponent has, for example, Fossies, it would be quite hard to win, so I think I have to mulligan once again. Okay, I will keep that. Put Chilean Conflict, or maybe land is better. Yeah, chill and land bottom. And try to top the like a dredger. Urza's throne. It's not the best hand to fight throne, I have to say. Okay, so I will use Forgotten Grave to try to draw into dredger. That's what I wanted to see. Okay. Easy. Right on time. Okay, I think I have to go for reunion. Like, I don't have time already. Now I'm searching for a green source because if opponent wants to play land card to eat my land, I want to have at least another green source in hand. Okay, come on. Power. Drawing Narcomoeba. It's exactly what I wanted to see. Also, meaning creeping chills early is not where I want to be. I want to flip creatures early because, like, creeping chill will always do the same. If you compare turn two, oh, nice. Natural throne. Opponent is very powerful. Okay, opponent decides to go for a mana. That's interesting. Opponent has Wurmcoil already, so I don't know what my opponent could have, so I can have. I'm just losing to Wurmcoil from this position. So I will just go for a Conflict for X2 and see what happens. Oh, that was a mistake. I should go for Conflict for 4 and attack with Bloody G at least to put my opponent a little bit lower. Nice. Well done. Okay. So, two grudges. I'm gonna play maybe one Nature's Claim and that's it. Side out one Bloody G, one Golgari Tak, one Merchant. And submit. So, maybe my opponent won't have everything. Like, Dredge can win against this type of draws. But you need to be on the play and you need to have turn to Narcomoeba Plasma Amalgams. You can play Forgotten Cave into Reunion to Dredge and then do stuff. Okay, I think it's keepable. It is quite sad that I have two Bloodgust in hand, but happens. When it goes down to 5. To 4. Wow, that's 2-3. That's a hard mulligan decision, I have to say. Okay, this land is extremely relevant because it lets me turn 3 Conflag and discard these two Bloodgusts and play a land to return them. So, I think think I want to play fetch land. Because there's a chance that if I play stomping ground, I can mill my colored sources. And for example, if I'm playing this stomping ground and I want to have Conflag plus, for example, Ancient Grudge, there's a quite big chance that I will mill my one stomping ground left. So in this position, it's better to fetch first. Finally, something does flip. Okay, my opponent at least won't have Tron yet. Okay, so we have more power, which is nice. Still, we haven't found any. Any conflicts. Okay, opponent considered, but. Like, I would go Lont, Loam, and next turn. Like, natural discard to bin one bloody G, and then Alpha 3. Game 3. On a draw, I like having more bloody G's instead of amalgams. Because there's a chance that opponent will have Relic up, so my Narcomiopas Amalgam on turn 2 is a little bit less likely. And like also, if you are a little bit from behind, it's better to have Hasty Threats, because you can flip Chills and then to attack with Bloody G's. Okay, this hand is fine. Like, it's not super broken, but I have Horn into Loam with Cycle Land plus Ancient Grudge. Opponent kept 7, I will also keep 7. So we'll see how it goes. Sure. That would be a perfect time to draw Nature's Claim, I have to say. Backcrop. Opponent. Ooh, nice. Clock already. Like, these early Narcomoebas are quite important in these type of matchups. Like, every bit of damage matters. Like, obviously it's better to have dredgers, but you can't underestimate two power on turn one, two. So I think about Forgotten Cave, just try to hit Bloody G's. Just play Forgotten Cave. Gorge next turn, Loam. To Forgotten Cave once again, because right now casting Loam is not that good. I'm not even returning Forgotten Cave, so cycle now. Oh, found Grudge. Can be relevant. Okay, we play a land. Like, that's a big trickiness, because I could play Copper Nine Gorge turn 1. And with Copper Ring of turn 1, I won't be able to cast Ancient Grudge. Now, on turn 2. Sure. So I guess it will be just another map with 2 mana up. So there's no need to use my Grudges now. So I will use Ancient Grudge more like a Whirlcoil Engine response. Okay, in response, we can mill more. Have one priced amalgam triggered. So the perfect timing would be dredge into more amalgams to return on opponent's end step to play around Eugene. So already 4 damage from creatures, which is nice. Okay, how many fetchables do I have left? 1, 2, 3. I have 2 left. So we can do cool tricks like. Okay, do I want to. Because I have 7 cards, so after casting Law and playing a land, I will have 8 in hand, so I will be able to discard 1 from hand, say. So I want to discard that G and play a fetch land. So I don't have to use my Forgotten Cave now. I can check what my opponent wants to do, and then if I play Eugene, I will be able to go crack fetch land response to Bloody G cycle to find my amalgams. So it will probably be better. So Forgotten Cave, and I guess Stomping Ground is the best one here. Maybe City of Brass is a bit better. Because there's also a chance that I will be forced to play, for example, Bloody G from hand. There's a difference between play and draw this matchup. On the play, I would be able to snipe both maps. Like, see, my situation is not the worst. Like, I have a response to Wurmcore. I can play around Eugene. Like, that's painful for sure, but it's beatable. So in second main phase, go for a Stomping Ground. Yes, in response to Bloody G, cycle to find maybe Amalgam. Easy. Okay, so we can go for, try to go for the kill, I think. Because if we flip 2 chills, or maybe 2 chills won't be little, but we'll be very close. If we flip Conflagrate, we will be able to shot for 7. Opponent will go down to 8, sorry, 9, and we have 9 power on board. So yeah, I think it's probably worth to go. Not to go for a better value in form of loan, but to dig for two cards to find Conflag. Never lucky. But we can kill Eugene. For example, play Imp, play Land, return 1 Bloodgust to return Amalgam to play around second Eugene. Maybe. Okay, we'll go for it. So we are killing Eugene. That's extremely rare to kill Eugene. Usually, this looks like opponent is playing minus 3 and you are killing opponent with hasty bloodcasts. Okay, so Imp, play City of Brass. I will return only one Bloody G to play a bit around second Eugene. Oblivion Stone versus Ancient Grushing Graveyard is not the best play. Fuck. Now it's better. Sure. So now I want to go for a life from the low, because like if I hit Conflag, it's a lot of damage to deal. And with Forgotten Cave, I'm able to dredge for 5 more. Probably Gemstone. So now use cycle to maybe. It's impossible to find what I want. Okay, so if I can't find my conf lag, it's better to cycle once again to find second creeping chill. Easy. Play a land, return three bloody G's. To tak. I have only 10 cards left, so maybe I won't dredge that hard anytime soon. On the other hand, like my cards, like I probably won't cast them either, so it's a no-brainer here. Maybe not no-brainer, but it won't affect my decisions very hard. Okay, opponent's at 4. We can kill him on board, even through Wurmcoil, and with Conflagrate. So opponent needs to have a chain of good cards here. He didn't have it.